is very useful tool in predicting the infrared spectroscopy, Raman spectroscopy, and electronic spectra about the polarity of the molecule. All such information could be obtained if you have a knowledge about the protein. Let me first of all introduce a group theory to you. Nature loves symmetry, no doubt about that. So you find out what are all the symmetry aspects present in your molecule, and based on them, classify the molecules into several point groups, we call it. What are the symmetry elements and symmetry operations present in a molecule? A symmetry element is a geometrical entity, and a symmetry operation is the operation which you perform using that geometrical entity. First of all, what is known as an axis of symmetry? Denoted as CL. It is an imaginary line passing through the molecule, and if you give a 360 degree rotation about this line as the axis, indistinguishable structures will repeat a number of times. How many times the indistinguishable structure appears? If it appears two times, we call the axis as twofold axis and denote as C2. A very simple example is water molecule. This is the axis of symmetry. I give a rotation about this axis. When I give a 180 degree rotation, what happens is B goes over here and A comes over here. This structure is an indistinguishable structure. I won't call it an identical structure, because A and B have exchanged their position. It is an indistinguishable structure, and this operation is called rotation. Both the element as well as the operation are denoted with the CL symbol. So I call this as a C2-1. Namely, I perform the operation of rotation using the C2 axis once. If I do it again, I call it C2-2, I get back the identical structure. This is an indistinguishable structure, and this is an identical structure. Element is the axis, operation is rotation. A number of molecules may possess this axis of symmetry. The next element is what is called a plane of symmetry. A plane divides a molecule into two identical halves, such that one is a mirror image of the other. Say, for example, I put a plane here. Again, I take water molecule. I cut the molecule here. It will give two identical halves. In another way, I can say like this. If I reflect the molecule in this plane, what I get is same thing. Just to distinguish, I put A here and B here. So B will appear here and A will appear here. So this plane produces an indistinguishable structure. The operation is called reflection, denoted as sigma. If I do it again, I call it sigma 2. Namely, reflection twice. What I get is, A comes over here and B comes over here. I get an identical structure. So sigma 1 produces indistinguishable structure and sigma 2 produces an identical structure. The planes have been classified into vertical plane, horizontal plane and dihedral plane. A vertical plane contains the major axis. A horizontal plane will bisect the major axis. That is called sigma h. A dihedral plane is a plane which bisects the angle between two central axes present in a molecule. Let me consider. Well, one more thing is, for water molecule, the molecular plane itself is a plane of symmetry. What I meant to say is, I can reflect in this plane. Or I can slice the molecule into two identical halves. As I told you, if it contains the major axis, it is called a vertical plane. If it bisects the major axis, it is a horizontal plane. In the case of water molecule, both the planes are vertical planes only. So vertical plane is indicated as sigma v. To illustrate what is a horizontal plane, let me consider a molecule P of 3. This contains a C3 axis. Namely, if you put an axis perpendicular to the board and give a rotation, let me label these atoms as A, B, and C. If I give a 120 degree rotation, I call it as C3-1. C goes over here, A comes over here, and B comes over here. This structure is an indistinguishable structure. I can rotate again. I call it C3-2, corresponding to a 240 degree rotation. And what I get is, B will go over here, C will come over here, and A will come over here. It's again an indistinguishable structure. And the operation is a 240 degree rotation starting from the initial structure. If I give a 120 degree rotation again, for the third time, I call it C3-3. Now I get A will come here, B will come here, and C will come here. This structure is an identical structure. So your C3 axis produces three operations, C3-1, C3-2, and C3-3. I can generalize now. Your CN axis produces N operations, CN1, CN2, etc., etc., up to CN power N. Well, this molecule contains three vertical planes. Namely, this is a vertical plane. This is a vertical plane. And this is a vertical plane. Three sigma v's are there. Remember, the major axis is perpendicular to the plane of the. Well, I can slice the molecule into two. That is also a plane of symmetry. So this is my plane. I slice the molecule. This plane is perpendicular to the major axis. So this plane I call as horizontal plane. So there are vertical planes, horizontal planes, and I also mentioned about a dihedral plane. Let me consider benzene of a molecule. Benzene. This is a simple axis. This is a simple axis. I have a plane here. You will note that this plane bisects the angle between the two simple axes. Such a plane I call as sigmoid, a dihedral plane. So there are three types of planes of symmetry. Vertical plane containing the major axis, the horizontal plane which bisects the major axis, and the dihedral plane which bisects the angle between the two simple axes and produce an indistinguishable section or two identical halves. So then we have what is called a rotation reflection axis, denoted as SN, rotation reflection axis. Rotation through a certain angle followed by reflection in a perpendicular plane. If this produces an indistinguishable structure, we call that axis as rotation reflection axis. If I say S2, I mean SE2 followed by sigma h. S4, SE4 followed by sigma h, so on and so forth. To give a very simple example, if we consider this model. I have chosen 1,2 trans dichloroethene. 1,2 trans dichloroethene. Let me put an axis here and give a 180-degree rotation. If I give a 180-degree rotation, the structure will appear like this. This CM will appear here. Let me label it as A and B. So B will come over here. And A will come over here. Let me label this hydrogen also as A and B. A will come out here and B will come out. This is the 180-degree rotation about this axis. This is not an indistinguishable structure. Well, now I am going to reflect the molecule in a perpendicular plane. Perpendicular to this axis is this plane. If I reflect so, what I get is A will appear here and B will appear. I reflected in a perpendicular plane. A and A, B and B. Okay. Now let me come back. It's a similar structure, not identical structure, a similar structure. Therefore, this axis, I can even call it as an S2 axis. And S2 is C2 followed by sigma h. Similarly, you have S3 molecules, C3 followed by sigma h, S6 in the molecule, C6 followed by sigma H, so on and so forth. And finally, another symmetry element that could be present in a molecule is identity. We denote it as E. The operation is, don't do anything. Leave it as it is. If you leave it as it is, then the molecule is similar to the original molecule. Why do you need this? Any set of elements to form a mathematical group, there should be one element which, when multiplied by any other element, leave it unchanged. In the case of numbers, one is such an element. Multiply one by any other number, the latter becomes unchanged. 1 into 15, 15. 1 into 18, 18. So this is a condition for a set of elements to form a mathematical group. So to fulfill that condition, we have introduced this identity. Therefore, the symmetry elements that are present in a molecule are an axis of symmetry, a plane of symmetry, a rotation reflection axis, an identity element, and one more is there, what is known as inversion. Inversion is, take the group or atom present at plus x to minus x and minus x to plus x. Plus y to minus y, minus y to plus y. Plus z to minus z, minus z to plus z. If you get an indistinguishable structure, then that point is called center of symmetry. Axis of symmetry is a line. Plane of symmetry is a plane and the center of symmetry is a point. To give a very simple example, 15. Consider this molecule. By inversion, this is a point here. About this point, I take this over there and that over here. This over there and that over here. It will give you an indistinguishable structure, not an identical structure. Do it again, I get identity. I can give one more example, maybe here, after tetrahedral complex. They all are water molecules. So if you take this over there and that one here, exchange positions, I get an indistinguishable structure. So this point is a set of symmetry. And the operation is called inversion. So totally, 5 elements of symmetry are there. Axis of rotation or axis of symmetry, plane of symmetry. In the plane there are 3 types, vertical, horizontal and dihedral. Rotation reflection axis, rotation followed by reflection in a perpendicular plane. Inversion and identity. All these are symmetry elements. As I mentioned, symbols are same. So C2 means an axis of symmetry, as well as it also implies a rotation, 180 degree rotation. Okay, based on the symmetry elements and symmetry operations, molecules have been classified into what are called point groups. Before we go into that details and predicting the condition for spectroscopy, let me introduce what's the character table For every point group, there is a character table that summarizes the symmetry properties of a molecule. I'm just going to explain them.